Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation. Amen. Trusting in the mercy of God, let us confess our sin. Reconciling God,
we confess that we do not trust your abundance, and we deny your presence in our lives. We place our hope in ourselves and rely on our own efforts. We fail to believe that you provide enough for all. We abuse your good creation for our own benefit. We fear difference and do not welcome others as you have welcomed us. We sin in thought, word, and deed. By your grace, forgive us. Through your love, renew us. And in your Spirit, lead us, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life. Amen.
Beloved of God, by the radical abundance of divine mercy, we have peace with God through Christ Jesus, through whom we have obtained grace upon grace. Our sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Come join the dance of Trinity before all worlds begun. The interweaving of the three, the Father, Spirit, Son. The universe of space and time did not arise by chance, but as the three in love and hope made room within their dance. Come see the face of Trinity, newborn in Bethlehem, then bloodied by a crown of thorns outside Jerusalem. The dance of Trinity is meant for human flesh and bone. When fear confines the dance in death, God rolls away the stone. Come speak aloud of Trinity, as wind and tongues of flame set people free at Pentecost to tell the Savior's name. We know the yoke of sin and death, our necks have worn it smooth. Go tell the world of weight and woe that we are free to move. Within the dance of Trinity, before all worlds begun, we sing the praises of the three, the Father, Spirit, Son. Let voices rise and interweave by love and hope set free, to shape in song this joy, this life, the dance of Trinity.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. You are God.
Glory to God in the heart. Pray. You are great, O God, and greatly to be praised. You have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they rest in you. Grant that we may believe in you, call upon you, know you, and serve you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and our Savior and Lord. Amen. A reading from Romans, the 7th chapter. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer that I do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now if I do what I do not want, it is no longer that I do it, but the sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self. But I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. God's word coming to us. Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew, the 11th chapter. Jesus spoke to the crowd, saying, "To what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another. We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn. For John came neither drinking or eating, and they say, 'He has a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, 'Look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by their deeds." At that time, Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you've hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle, humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. For the yoke is easy, and my burden is light." God's word coming to us. Thanks be to God.
Hi, St. Paul. Welcome to Time of Children. The verses this week are from the Gospel of Matthew. And the one that stands out to me the most of our text for this week is verse 28. And it says, "Come to me, all you that are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." What is the heaviest thing that you've ever tried to carry? Something like a whole bunch of groceries to help your parents out after the grocery store, or maybe you've tried to pick up your brother or sister. Find something in your house that's heavy to hold in one hand, but you can still hold it. Pause now if you need to go find something. I found this. It's a big, heavy book about hockey. We're a big hockey family. Now, what I want you to do is hold it in your hand while you sing Jesus Loves Me with me. You ready? Just one hand. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Woo! Was it harder to hold that the longer that we sang it together? It was for me. My arm started to get a little bit tired and my fingers. In our verse, Jesus talks about heavy burdens. Heavy burdens, like Jesus is talking about, could be anything that makes you feel really sad, frustrated, scared. And when we feel those things for a long time, like all day or many days in a row, they become really heavy to us. They put us in a bad mood or just kind of make us feel sad for a while. Jesus doesn't want us to feel the weight of how heavy things can be in life sometimes. So what do? We can pray and we can tell Jesus how we feel. That's just a conversation. A prayer is just a conversation with Jesus. And we tell Jesus everything that we are feeling. Good, bad, sad, frustrated. We can worship, and right now worship online or drive-in worship, and hear reminders of how much Jesus loves us when we sing songs or we hear liturgy. We can read verses in the Bible like this one from Matthew and remember that Jesus wants us to feel his peace. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for reminding us today about how much you love everyone. Help us to share your peace with others who are weary and carrying heavy burdens. Amen. Have a great week.
While walking our dog last night, I saw DeLorean stop at the light, and I thought to myself, might not want to stay in 2020 too much longer there, Marty. There are plenty of jokes and memes about how momentous 2020 has been. This year has me asking all kinds of questions in the light of this passage. What are we to do with this generation, with this time, with this age? There's no doubt that this time will be marked in the history books as something. What will it say? I'm also curious about what the reports of history will not say. What part of 2020 will fall to the editing floor like some form of forgotten children of history, like children who do not get the attention they are seeking? I also wonder whose demons will need to be exorcised and what greed and consumption will become laid bare before the critical eye of history. What will history reveal to us? Because I fear right now that we're just too close to see what's actually going on, too close to understand it, too close to grasp what really is happening. What will be revealed to us by generations after us reading the story of now? On top of all that, what faith will they see? What will the church be known for in this time? Were we a part of the problems of the day or the parts of the solutions? What difference are we making? And what movement are we causing in the grand arc of the kingdom of God coming into this creation? God has promised grace. God has chosen us for God's grace. Don't let anything or anyone convince you otherwise. But every day we have a myriad of choices to make. Choices that make a difference. Choices that can change the world one step at a time. As a people of faith, we represent the faith. So we have the ability to what we are known for. If we take a clue from this gospel message today, we are to be known as people who lay down burdens. We are about laying down our burdens. We are here to shed the pounds of generations of misuse and abuse to ourselves and others. We come into worship confessing our sins, laying ourselves bare before God, being vulnerable before God. In our faith, our sins are no longer building a wall before us and God. The burden of the idea that God holds our sins against us is a burden that does not exist when we yoke ourselves to Jesus. When we yoke ourselves to Jesus, we are released from the demand that we must please God to get grace. We are released from the understanding that we are supposed to dance for God to get God's attention, that we must wail to hear from God. In Christ, we have a God that is revealed as mercy, humility, and full of heart. So we lay our burdens down before God. And as we do that, we yoke ourselves to the grace and forgiveness that we find in Jesus Christ. Yet, that is not the only way in which we lay burdens down. We are also called to help prevent and act to remove burdens, generational burdens, burdens that fall disproportionately on the oppressed. Burdens that we have caused or participated in or have given permission to. Even the burdens that others have, that we even have benefited from the existence of those burdens. We are called to lay down and to build up, to deconstruct and to construct a burdenless society. We are called to confront the aspects of the world that place an unjust burden on those who have been bearing it for generations. And to be honest, our lack of action makes us culpable. Culpable of making the burdened glorify their oppression before we pay attention. And that's what I'm afraid history will remember about us. And for those of us bearing the weight of faith around us, this yoke of Christ, this is our work. We are supposed to be creating a burdenless society through faith. A life with Christ is meant to be burdenless for all. We are to shed the pounds of injustice that weigh us down. Pounds that cause undue burden on all. Yes, I do believe that the yoke of Christ is easy. But it is easy for a purpose and for a reason, so that we may focus on the work of the kingdom. And this work that we are in is not easy. Sometimes it may feel like a burden. Yet, I think that's part of the point. The point is that our relationship with God is meant to be easy. But God wants the borders down, the lanes clear, the red tape torn between us and our neighbor, like he's done for us between us and God. And this happens. This happens so that we can put the work in here on earth. God tears down the borders. God tears down the lanes. God tears down the red tape between us and God so that we can go to work creating a burdenless world that looks just a bit more like the kingdom of God. And when our story has been told and when the history is written, this is the church that I want to be reminded of. This is the legacy in which we have to give to the generations after us. That we today, right now, create a burdenless society for the sake of all creation. Amen.
Whole creation, let us pray for our shared world. We pray for the church. Sustain us as we share your word. Embrace us as we struggle to find our common ground. Lift up leaders with powerful and prophetic voices. Free us from stagnant faith. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We pray for the well-being of creation. Protect the air, water, and land from abuse and pollution. Free us from apathy and our caring in our care of creation, and direct us towards sustainable living. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We pray for the nations. Guide leaders in developing just policies and guide difficult conversations. Free us from patriotism that hinders relationship building. Lead us to expansive love for our neighbor. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We pray for all who are in need, for all who are tired, feeling despair, sick, or oppressed. We pray for Dorothy Cardi, who suffers from an infected knee. We pray for Aloha, Henry, Ellen, Amy, Mary, Father John, Robin, Sarah, Linda, Jean, Richard, Bob, Matthew, Elaine, Trish, Karen, Fred, Shirley, Kathy, Janice, Lucille, Eleanor, Carl, Steve, Andrew, Jeff, Robin, Chuck, and Roger. Take their yoke upon you and ease their burdens. Give your consolation and free us from all that keeps us bound. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We pray for this congregation. Bless congregational leaders who energize volunteers, church administrators, and those who maintain our building. Shine in this place that we might notice the ways your love transforms our lives. We pray for our mission partners, Samaritas Family Center, Families First, and Heartline. We pray for Gleaners, Crossroads, Iroquois Food Pantry, and Freedom House. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Receive these prayers, O God, and those too deep for words. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us take a moment of peace with our neighbors in our household and with each other through this camera. Let's breathe deep. Amen. As a restful and burden-less people, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive this blessing. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation, we will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God, our Creator, Jesus, the Christ, the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal love. Amen. Go in peace. Christ is with you. Amen. Thanks be to God. Go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God.
Take these hands. Worship's over. I'm just kidding.